Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Nathan from mastersofmusic.com. For this video, I'm going to do a comparison review between the Audient IED4 here on the left and the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 here on the right. And I've also mentioned the differences between the Scarlett 2i4, which I also happen to have, the first gen right here. This thing is a beast compared to these two, obviously way bigger. I'll talk about the differences between it as well. So I've got these interfaces recently. I posted a review of the 2-on-2 last month and a comparison with it in the 2-on-4. So I've still been having some issues with the drivers on the 2-on-2. So I wanted to give the ID4 a shot. So let's go ahead and just talk about their features first. So they're very similarly priced. This is like 200 bucks. It's the same price as the 2-on-4, and then the 2-on-2 is like 50 bucks cheaper. So they're all sort of in the same category. They're all 2x2 interfaces. Well, actually the 2-on-4 is 2x4 because that has the 4. But they're all very similar features wise, and they also have like very good build quality. They're both made out of metal, so they got metal knobs and metal casing. So they both have good solid build quality. With the ID4 here, we got some different output layouts. So it's got the dual connector here on the back for mics and line input. It's got the 48 volt phantom switch right there, and then we got the main outs, and then of course the USB port right here. And then on the front, it has the direct input for connecting like guitars and basses. You can just record with that. And then you've got the dual headphone output, so it's got one of both sizes for the headphone out. So the headphone out is tied to the main out, so it's not a separate out like it is. You can set the separate out on the 2-on-4. So with the 2-on-2, the 2-on-2, it's got the two combo connectors, so you could connect two mics at once and record both of those at the same time using this device. So that's like one advantage as far as having two combo connectors. And then we've also got the separate dial for the volume, so you could actually have your monitors and your headphones at different volume levels. With the ID4, you have them at the same level, or you can mute the speakers. So it's just a little bit of difference right there. Another difference, 2-on-2 right here has a direct monitor switch, which will mix them. I think it's just a 50-50 mix for direct monitor and your DAW mix there. And then it has the switches for line input and instrument input. And then with the gains here, I'll show you in a second, I'll plug in a guitar and show you how the halos work for the gain indicators. With this one right here, we've got the knobs for the separate, the individual knob here for the direct input, and then the mic preamp right there. And then this is your direct monitor switch. So you have more direct monitor, you can blend it with this one. And then when you go all the way into the left, it'll give you your indicator for your input here, which I'll show you in a second. And then we've also got the mute button, so that'll mute your speakers. And then the ID4 button, this is kind of a unique feature with this interface. When you have this button enabled, it makes this a mouse wheel essentially. So any parameter you can adjust with the mouse wheel, you could activate and use this to turn those as well. So you can use it to adjust parameters in your DAW, or you could just use it to scroll through libraries or anything like that. So it's kind of a unique feature, and it also will drop the volume by 15 decibels if you tap it while you're listening, so you can get a quick drop in the sound source if you want to do that as well. And then we got the indicators up here for the status for when it's connected to your USB, and then the 48 volt light right there. So then with the back of the 2i2, I forgot to show here, it's just very basic. We just got the main outputs right there. We got the Kensington lock and the USB port. So that's pretty much it with the 2-on-2. So let me show you guys the 2-on-4 really quick, so you can get an idea, since these are both at the same price range, the ID4 and the 2-on-4, or the 2-on-4, yeah. They're the same price range, so look at that. Obviously the ID4, it's almost half the size of the 2-on-2, or the 2-on-4. This thing's pretty large by comparison. So the advantages with this one, so this one has a direct playback knob as well, just like the ID4, so you can blend the sources if you want. So this one has that as well. And then a thing that separates this one is it has the four channels, so you can set the output to 3 and 4 if you want to have your headphones separate from the main output. So that's the other main difference with this, is we have the additional connectors in the back here. You've got the RCA connectors. You've also got MIDI in and out. So the ID4 doesn't have any MIDI connectors. So that will give an advantage for the 2i4, definitely right there. So I'm not gonna really talk about the 2i4 anymore because this is the first gen. So I'm gonna keep this as basically a comparison between the second gen Scarletts. So the way you monitor like the input from your mic or your guitar on the ID4 is you have to turn this knob all the way to the white section right here where the input shows. And then it will show the input, like when you strum your guitar, it'll show up here, show you how hot your signal is, so you can adjust it accordingly. And then with the Focusrite Scarlett, it's a bit different because it always gives you your indicator. So when you're on the ID4 and you have it anywhere but the white section right here, so when you have it listening to your DAW for playback, you don't get the indicator for your inputs, you get it'll show the indicator for the outputs, what it'll do. So the way with the Scarless is, it will show you your signal all the time. Anytime you're playing, you always have that light indicator. And then once you get up into the clipping zone, it'll go red. It actually goes yellow or orange before it goes red. So you do have that indicator all the time on the Focusrite Scarlets, whereas on the ID4, you only have it when you're in the input section over there. All right, so when it comes to like the output sound quality, I kind of feel like the ID4 has a slight edge. I mean, it's not a big difference, but it just seems like the low end has a little bit more detail to it. Like you can kind of feel the punch of the bass drum a little bit more. The Focusrite Scarlets, they just seem a little bit more flat to me, like they're a little bit more emphasized in like the upper or mid range. I don't know, it just could be me. I wouldn't put a whole lot of stock in that because it's very subjective. But when it comes to the DI sound quality of these two, they sound identical to me. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you a recording that I did. I did a recording with the same exact settings on both of these. I just plugged the guitar in, tried to match the level as much as possible. And to me, the two sounds sound exactly the same. So let me go ahead and let you guys be the judge. I'll run that right now. So another advantage with the Scarlets is they come with some software. You got like Ableton Live Lite, which I was just showing with the DI comparison. It comes with that. It comes with some plugins. So the ID4 actually doesn't come with any bonus software at all. But the ID4 has a couple of those extra features, like you can use that as a scroll wheel, and you got the mute button right there. You've also got an advantage with the ID4 is the fact that it supports iOS. It works with iOS 6 and later. The Scarlets only work with Mac and Windows. So when it comes to the preamps, mic preamps, I'm not qualified to tell you if they're good or bad, but I'm not gonna go ahead and judge the preamps because I don't even deal with vocals. I'm a guitarist, I work with guitars. That's where the DI signal is important to me. Also, latency is very important because I work with amp sims. The Focusrite Scarlets definitely have the edge in latency. You can get all the way down to 3 milliseconds of latency, like working latency on the Focusrite second gen right here. I can only get it to 9.3 on the ID4 milliseconds. With my Windows 7 computer, it can go down to 4 milliseconds at 64 samples, but it won't run at 64 samples on my computer. Even at zero CPU usage, it just crackles like crazy. So 64 samples is out with this one. The Scarlets, they have higher support for higher sample rates, so it goes all the way up to like 196, and then they'll record fine at 32 samples on my computer. So for whatever reason, the ID4 won't work at the highest settings, or the Scarlet will work at the highest settings, but I have some problems with the drivers on the Scarlet. So I've had a few blue screens, it freezes on my computer occasionally, and I'm constantly having to toggle the buffer size to get it to reset, or it does these weird CPU spiking things. So I don't have any of those problems on the ID4, but like I said, the latency is higher, so it's kind of a toss-up. These two are very evenly matched. I honestly don't know which one to go with yet. I'm leaning towards the ID4. If Focusrite updates the drivers and fixes them on the second chain here, then I might be inclined to keep it. But I mean, it's a really even match here. So I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this review right here. Check out mastersofmusic.com for more info. I have a dedicated review for the 212. I also have a comparison with it, the 214, if you wanted to check that out. So I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this review. Thank you guys for watching. Have a good day.